prepared a gluten-free meal for you because, of course, we try to eat gluten-free around here because we recommend it to our patients. And what you're having this afternoon is pumpkin soup with marshmallows, which are also gluten-free, I found out. And then you have a salad that has all kinds of fall things in it, like nuts and pomegranate and apples. And it's pretty tasty with an orange, what's the salad dressing?
It's a maple orange
salad dressing. I only made it last night. So I did make all of this myself. I went shopping at Central Market, and I cooked till midnight, and then I got up and came in and put the salads together. So this is a labor of love. And it's very important in our family, both my work family and my home family, that we eat together. And you can be looking for my next book, which will come out, I hope, sometime next year. I haven't started writing it yet, but it's called Breaking Bread, and it's about how important it is to eat together as a family. I want you all to know that we're also on Facebook, and if you go on our Facebook, you're going to see two videos a week about food. One is what the fresh foods are in season, fruits and vegetables, and then the other will be a recipe. And you'll get the recipe for whatever the food was that was featured. And Megan, who's in the back of the room, is our person who does those videos. We all kind of get together and collaborate on what our recipes might be. So if you go on Facebook, like us on Facebook, and then you'll get our posts. And we would love to have your email address if we don't already, because we do send out periodic emails. We don't inundate you, but we have events monthly, and this month coming up, we have also got our open house November 9th. You're all invited. It's from noon till 7 p.m., and that's a Friday. So without further ado, I'm going to leave you with Dr. Kotsanis and go ahead and have some lunch, and we'll get questions at the end.
Well, welcome, everyone. Thanks for coming. As always, we like to share with you health. And health begins with good planning and understanding what one needs to do to stay healthy. As we see here, before I go any further, I just want to say I'm obligated by law to tell you that this is integrative medicine. I'm a medical doctor, trained as a surgeon. I'm not a pediatrician. And I'm not a neurologist. So what you're about to hear is the experience of 30 plus years of medicine and also research. So we're just going to jump into the subject today, which is proper nutrition. Looking at your table, I agree with everything that Beverly did. And of course, I can't disagree with her. She's my wife. But I do not agree with the marshmallows. But nevertheless, that's too much sugar. But it's okay to have some sugar. So we're just going to go ahead and start with proper nutrition and digestion. The foundation of health begins with nutrition. We know if you look at healthcare today, it's so expensive, and most people cannot touch it the way it is, because it's based on a sick system. Basically, if you have a sickness, then we give you a pill to make you feel better. There is nothing wrong with Western medicine, except that it's too expensive. It does not address the underlying cause, and that's what we're going to study today. And the underlying cause really begins with good nutrition. You will see, no matter what part of the world you come from, you will find scientists that will agree when everything else fails, nutrition works. So why don't we start with nutrition? To start nutrition, you have to go a little bit further, and you look into the way that we grow food. So the farming comes first. It has to be organic as much as possible, and then it has to be harvested correctly, and then brought to the grocery store to be brought to your kitchen, and then it has to be properly prepared. And we have combinations are critical. Eating and drinking is critical. So we're going to go through all that. So in our institute, we do a comprehensive history and physical in the beginning. Usually we like to spend a couple of hours with you to see what we need to do and understand your point of view. And then we try to find a highly specific approach for you, designed for you. So the basic principles would be, you have to say good nutrition and good digestive system. The digestive system is very critical because it's the entry point and the exit point, entry point for the good nutrients, the exit point for the toxins. They are together with the kidneys, of course. But the digestive system is so very critical because it has many functions. You're talking about digestion, absorption. It also has the beneficial flora in the gut. There are 200 trillion with the T bacteria and friendly fungi there to help us digest the food, make things that we cannot make. And then we look at the neuroendocrine health. The brain controls everything and works together with the digestive system, because what goes on in the digestive system goes on in the brain. So we need to pay attention to that. And of course, the other system that is critical is the immune system. So the immune system defends you from diseases, and pretty much is the most benign system in your body. If I had to pick one as a friend, I will always pick the immune system, because it sorts things for us, eliminates the toxins, and allows things to enter the mitochondria to make energy and all that. So the immune system is key here. And without detoxification, let's remember this. If you go back a couple hundred years before the Industrial Revolution, dig up one of your great ancestors and look at their bones for toxicity. They had very little toxicity. If you go back now, let's say, dig up the most recent relative that passed away and check their bones, they have 2,500 times the toxicity that they had a couple hundred years ago, which means everyone in this office is toxic compared to your ancestors. All of us have toxicity because we encounter approximately 700,000 chemicals that we didn't a couple hundred years ago. So we need to have a good digestive system and a good detoxification system in order to get the chunk out. In the computer science, say, garbage in, garbage out. So you cannot, blame just the environment today. You have to be very careful. So please study nutrition and other good things for you, what is good for your body. And you have to ask the question before you put something in your mouth. Is this immunosupportive or immunosuppressive? If it's immunosuppressive, then you don't want to touch it. So we're going to see later a pyramid that we have about that. So the thing is, we see people, brain injury is commonplace these days. Children are toxic. People that are super athletes, they get concussions, they're toxic. People that fight for us to protect us from our enemies, and they far away lands, and they have PTSD, they're toxic. So what do we do to help these people? We need to understand the connection between the nutrition, the digestive system, and the brain. It's a connection. We must make that connection, because we can help people with spectrum disorders, from autism to ADHD to ADD, etc. We can help people with Alzheimer's, people with brain injuries, etc. So this is about, this is again, like Beverly was saying earlier, this is a labor of love. And I've turned the pyramid upside down because that's the way it is. Now the pyramid, the way you know it, and most of us know it, is it was designed by the dairy industry back in 1933, thereabouts, in order to sell their stuff. They've done a good job. They say there are 4 food groups. Chemically, there are only 3 food groups. We have proteins, fats, and sugars. So now what they did, they came up with the 4 food groups, and they say we have the dairy products. They threw eggs in, which has all 3 food groups in it, and the other things to entice you to buy their stuff. And they've done a very good job. They've convinced everybody. Don't misunderstand me. I like milk products too. They taste good. But most of the time, unless it's human milk, they're immunosuppressive. Okay? So if God wants us to have milk all our lives, our mothers would have made milk all their lives. So usually, for the first couple of years, is designed for the child to be breastfed, whenever possible, as much as possible, to have a healthy outcome. And of course, after 2 years, you don't need milk. Okay. But nevertheless, but we created the pyramid here. So if you take the human body, you grind them down to flour, and you biochemically examine the different components. 70% is water. It has to be good water, structured water. And then you have another 20% is protein. Another 10% is everything else. And if you see way, way down here, there has to be good carbohydrates. So if you look at the pyramid that they have commercially for the past 70 plus years, what is it, close to 100 years, is the other way around. That's why we have so much sickness. So although we need to have the carbs for energy and all that, and they have some good, if they're complex, if they're organic, of course they're good. All of them are good, but these are the proportions that you really need. Also, we've seen in studies, people that are healthy, the less you eat, the longer you're going to live, and the less disease you're going to have. So you need to watch what you're eating. If you do WeightWatchers.com, you will see, you know, glycemic foods have a low glycemic index. Is critical. And how many calories you eat. The load also is good. For example, I say, oh, gee, apples are good. Let me have, 10,000 calories of apples. I'm just sitting down because they're good for me. No, because the glycemic load is high. So you have to eat a normal portion in low glycemic. So and we have a book that we came out about 3-4 months ago. You're welcome to purchase it here if you wish. It talks about a lot of good things about nutrition, toxicity, and other things. So what's the common link? Nutrition is the foundation. And like I said earlier, when we have chronic diseases, and we do treat here chronic diseases that nobody wants to touch, like cancer and chronic fatigue and autistic spectrum and diabetes, things that are, you go to your doctors, they've done everything for you, they say, we can't help you any further, and then we all agree that everything else doesn't work, try nutrition. Try eating correctly, thinking correctly, eliminating correctly. That's all critical. So the cleansing and healing of the digestive tract results in the proper absorption of the nutrients. So when you look at the digestive system, the way we eat, if you don't believe me, go to the shopping mall this Saturday or Sunday, sit there, put your hands like this, and watch the people walking by you under 30 years of age. One-third of them are obese. If you're grossly obese, if they're obese, it means that you're not healthy. You're carrying too many toxins in your body, because the body is going to take the toxins and deposit them in the most inaccurate system, which is the fat is the most inaccurate system in your body. That's where it's deposited. So if you have too much fat, that means you have too many toxins. So as you lose, now a lot of people say, well, gee, I'm 100 pounds overweight. I'm going to go a starvation diet. I want to drop 100 pounds. Be careful. You got to do it right, because if you lose your fat too quickly, you're going to metabolize the toxins that are stored in the fat that's going to cause you more problems than you have. So it's to be a systematic reduction. You have to clean up the liver first, clean up the digestive system first before you do something like this. It has to be supervised. If you want to lose 10, 15 pounds, I understand. But if you're 50, 60, 100 pounds overweight, it must be supervised, right? So the digestive system plays an important role in the overall function of the body, including the brain. Earlier I said that the brain is connected to the gut. We know the brain hormones, another name for these neurotransmitters. The neurotransmitters are the brain hormones. And whatever we find in the brain, you find in the gut. So if we want to know how the brain is, it's easier to look in the gut than to look in the brain, because it's not as accessible. Although we have methods of doing it, but they're very expensive. So we're trying to look at the base, look at the nutrition, look at the digestive system first, and look at the immune system before you graduate to the brain. But if you fix those in that order, the brain usually automatically corrects itself. So proper nutrition, so we know that proteins are critical, and we know that most red meats are not good for you, and once in a while, I guess you can eat anything, but fish, which scales and bones, cannot be farm-raised, because farm-raised is like eating catfish. So it's shameful for you to go and eat, let's say, tilapia or something that is expensive, and really eat catfish with a different name, because the farm raised, they feed them corn and other junk. It doesn't have any fatty acids. You know, you're looking for the fatty acids, and of course they have to be to eat algae, and there's no algae in the farm raised fish. Okay, so that's not a good idea. So it has to be scales and bones. It has to be wild. The smaller the fish, the better off you are, because of bioaccumulation of toxins. Now, let me go back here on proteins. Some people who like to be vegan, they do extremely well being vegan. But if you just eat vegan diet, you're missing the protein and you're going to be cachexic. So there was an Italian company that came and, I don't know the name of them, but they call it MAP, Master Amino Protein. And they tested this. They put the essential amino acids in. Essential means your body cannot make them. You got to eat it from an outside source. And they did a study where they gave them the MAP for protein. That's the only protein they ate. And the rest of it was vegan. And they thrived like crazy. So those of you that are completely vegan, we do carry the supplement called MAP, M-A-P. And you can take anywhere between 2 grams, 3-4 times a day. If you're an athlete, you need as much as 30 grams a day. And we have some athletes here that have done that and done extremely well. So there is a solution for you if you say, gee, I'm not going to eat red meats. I don't want to eat fish because it has too much mercury. I don't want to eat eggs because it's all these things. But you do need the essential amino acids. So if you take the MAP together with a good variety of nutrition and some supplementation, you can avoid eating any of these meat and fish, etc. What if you just, if you take the MAP, can you eat the other animal protein, the fish and the meat? Yes, you can. It doesn't exclude you from eating other, you know, animal products. I'm just saying, if you really want to be strict about, you need to detoxify people that have severe problems with diabetes, cancer, Lyme's, etc. And they need good protein, that's a good source. And you take it, you grind it, you put it in a coffee grinder, You drink it with water. It has no taste. Also, you can take it in the form of pills, but some people can't take pills. They do big pills like this. So grind them, put them in water, drink it first thing in the morning, about half an hour before you eat anything else. And it's really a wonderful supplement. Then we look at fats. Now, fats have been misunderstood. People, the pharmaceutical industry wants you to believe that all fats are bad for you. That's not true. The good fats and bad fats. Okay, you need fats because the cell walls of every cell in your body is made out of these proper fats. So they control the traffic between inside the cell and outside the cell. They control the electricity. That's where the electricity of the cell is held. You must have roughly a minus 70 millivolts of charge in order for the cell to work. What is the charge held? It's held in the cell wall. So it has many properties. So eating the correct fats is critical. So if they're rancid, the thing that they confuse us, they say, gee, this is a rancid fat. So most people don't think, what's rancid? It's just another word. Most people don't stop and think. Let's call them rotten fats, because that's what they are. Would you eat a rotten steak? Would you eat a rotten hamburger or a rotten chicken? No. A rotten apple? No. Well, why would you eat rotten fat called rancid fats? That's what they are. Popcorn, you put all the butter they put on there, it's rancid, it's spoiled fats. So don't eat them. Very simple. So the best, we're going to come next year, we're looking to do a lot of research, and we're working with a scientist out of Greece right now that he has proven, and I need to have the documentation, he's going to send me the literature, that olive oil is the best fat, if it's properly harvested, is the best fat you can possibly eat. Fish oil is another great fat. And so it has to be, you cannot cook them. Ideally, if you cook them, you will destroy, you will change the chemistry. So fats is critical. Fried fats is out. Microwave is out. Anything fried is out. Then we'll look at sugar. Now that's the biggest killer in the universe. The difference between sugar and heroin, heroin will kill you in 2 years. Sugar will kill you in 20 years. No difference. Okay? So really, Processed sugars, we're talking about processed sugars here. Because everything you eat, the apples you're going to eat today, they have fructose. This is a form of sugar. But processed sugar, all the diet drinks and all that, that's all trash. Okay? So please stay out of it. Now, if you were to drink a soft drink, you also screw up the pH in your body. Ideally, you have to have a pH around 7. 6.8 to 7.1, 7.2 is ideal. Most of us, if you're an American, you have a pH of about 6.5 or less. So we're going to push it towards 7. Let's assume you have a soft drink, a small soft drink. Any company, not endorsing or condemning any company, they're all the same. And you want to neutralize the pH of one soft drink, 8-ounce soft drink. You have to drink 400 glasses of water for every soft drink you take in order to neutralize it. Okay, so sugar is out. Again, complex carbohydrates are in. Proper carbohydrates found in fruit and found in complex. You'll find it everywhere. Everything has a little bit of sugar and everything has a little protein in it. So you can avoid it. But I'm saying, if you know, for example, you're going to eat cakes and cookies and potato chips and all that, that's all low with sugar. Now, it goes back to 600 BC. They recognized we have, you know, sweet and salt and bitter and sour. These are the tastes. And they say, you need to balance, as far back as 600 BC, they were saying, you must balance the senses. You must balance the taste. So you have to be a balance between salt and sweet and sour and bitter. Now we know that sour and bitter, anything that is good for you is sour and bitter. Okay, it has tremendous properties. Not only kills, it brings all the electrons in that we need, it also detoxifies you, but also kills the fungi that don't belong in your gut, the bacteria, no, they do not like. So dark and tart is the new green. So if you remember that, that's good. Then let's look at the digestive system again. The body's immune competence and ability to function properly are directly tied to its ability to eliminate waste and toxins. Now we know that the digestive system, there are three systems that live in it. The digestive system, the immune system, 70% of it lives there, and the primitive brain. We have 100 billion cells of neural cells in the gut. And if I'm sure all of us have sat next to people from time to time, this man, I don't know this guy, but I just got to move. Why? Because it has the electromagnetic fields do not agree with you. So that's what that is. If you say, I have a gut feeling this is a good thing or a bad thing, that's your brain. Your primitive brain is telling you to listen. Listen to your primitive brain. Okay? Become like a child. Uninhibited and with no prejudice. And that's what you know. The primitive brain knows. So if you put something in your mouth, it tastes bad, or you feel bad after you eat it, don't eat it again. You don't need to go spend thousands of dollars to identify what it is. Just don't do it. So treatment of the digestive tract must be highly specific for each individual. Some people need more fish oil. Some people need more probiotics, enzymes, etc. It is reasonable to consider enzymes with meals and between meals. Because with meals, if you're going to eat right before you start eating, if you have problems, there's a test that shows you if you have a problem, you take some digestive enzymes at the beginning of the meal. And then combination of how you eat is also critical. You cannot eat and drink at the same time. Ideally, the water you're supposed to drink 20 minutes before you start eating, and then don't eat, have a glass of water or whatever you have in front of you in case you choke, take a couple swallows. But if you go to a restaurant, they sit down and say, oh, my name is Joe and I'm going to be your waiter. What can I get you? And they push the drinks on you. Now, of course, that's a business decision on the part of the restaurant. My father used to own a restaurant and that's what we used to do. I know the game, okay? So do not eat and drink at the same time. So ideally speaking, 20 minutes before you start eating, drink all the water you want. Stop. Put a glass of water or tea, whatever, in front of you. Take your supplements. If you need to take a sip, go ahead and do so. And ideally, again, finish eating. Let's say if you eat lunch at 12, and you finish it. So you drink water at 20 minutes to 12, 12 to 12:15 or 12:30, you finish eating. and then don't drink again until about at least an hour or two after you stop eating, because you will dilute the enzymes in your gut. If you dilute the enzymes, that's a problem. So we won't do that. So that's critical. So in order to, if you have a correct, the flora, not only parasites, parasites exist everywhere. Fungi exist everywhere. If you decide to eat, to breathe, or to drink ever again in your life, you will come in contact with beneficial flora and will come in contact with harmful organisms. If the immune system is way the heck up here, then of course you're not going to have any problems with your health. So we need to eat correctly and take proper measures, clean up the house. I know that Hilda Clark said if you have pets, you get parasites. And the other thing to remember, when you prepare your food, you're from the grocery store, ideally speaking, it's all in our book, by the way, if you want to see the details. It tells you to take rinse them out, put them in the sink, go ahead and put a cup and a half of peroxide to kill the parasites for about a half an hour or so, shake it a couple of times, drain it, fill it up with water again, put a cup and a half of apple cider vinegar in the mix, let it sit there for 15, 20 minutes. Now you kill the parasites, number one, and number two, you detach all the surface toxins that are sprayed, that they're gone. I remember when I was a kid, you go to the grocery store, and you go to the area where they sell apples, for example, and you will find a couple, three apples you see worms crawling around, and because they were naturally grown. Now you go to any grocery store right now, you bring me an apple like this, I'll give you $100. It doesn't exist. They have 17 coats of toxins to prevent them from being spoiled. So when you clean the fruit for the parasites, you also clean the toxins with it. So that's a good thing. Immunity, my favorite system in the body. I guess the brain would be my second, but immunity is my first. But this works as a symphony. You cannot have good immunity if you don't have good nutrition. You cannot have a clean digestive system if you don't have good immunity. So immunity, digestive system, nutrition, and the brain, they kind of work on that. That's the board of directors. Now some would say the brain is the boss, and it's supposed to be, but usually it's not. The immune system usually is the boss if we think correctly and do things right. And if we don't think correctly, then the digestive system becomes the boss. And when the digestive system is the boss, then you're in trouble. You have to eat correctly. You support the digestive system, because 70% of the immune system lives at the bottom of the digestive system. For example, if my socks is the digestive system, the soles of my shoes is the immune system. So if I have thick socks and choke the immune system, then of course the immune system cannot do its job. So we need to be very careful with it. So we like to control the allergies. Many ways of doing it, from supplementation to good nutrition, avoiding sugar, etc. But because we live in a toxic world, we need some help. We have a form of treatment called low antigen. It was invented in England about 70 years ago. In Europe, they call it EPD, enzyme potentiation desensitization. We did a study back in the mid-90s. We had about 1,700 people on the study. It was a nationwide study. Our clinic was one of the participants. And of course, it was working phenomenally well. 90% of the inhalant allergies were gone away, and 80% of the foods and 70% of the chemicals. You're talking about the best thing since sliced bread. Nevertheless, because the American system, they want to test that you can only make claims if you have one thing. Which one thing did this? Well, it's not one thing. It's about 15, 20, 30 things. So they say, well, we can't call it EPD anymore. So now we call it LDA. And it that's not the only way to treat. The traditional, I'm also an allergist, and traditional allergy also works. I think this is more convenient and less expensive. And it really works. It works for chemicals, it works for foods, and it works for inhalants. And you take a shot every 2 months the first year, every 3 months the second year, every season to every 6 months the third year. So it's conveniently, it's here. And if you combine this with nutrition, that you have a better outcome. That's how you control the allergies. And sometimes we also use some homeopathics to support the immune system for infections. Then we look at the brain. Now the brain is very tricky. 99% of the brain is there to control you. It's a control freak. Only 1% is doing other things. But we do need the controls, don't misunderstand. We must have the controls. But when things get out of hand, we have different waves in the wavelengths in the head. And we have clear mind is a technology. It's a patent technology, and we do have it here. And what it does, it looks the brain in general, the trauma, depression, anxiety, mental status, activity, PTSD, all these things, insomnia, it looks at different parts of the brain. Different parts of the brain have predominant waves. So when you do the testing, you will see, for example, area A is supposed to be, let's say, theta, but it doesn't have theta, it has something else in it. So you look at the brain as the first time, and you see what's off. And then you do these treatments to normalize, to bring the proper wavelengths in the proper area of the brain. And by doing so, it's biofeedback. It's been around for a very long time. Neurologists have been using it for a very long time. And I think it's one of the best systems that we have to control the brain to some extent. And of course, so what this biofeedback, what it does, it trains the brain waves, interrupts ineffective mental patterns, and lifts out of non-productive thoughts. So it also controls your depression and thoughts. So normalizes, the whole thing is to be a normal human being, you gotta be happy and healthy. So this also will return you to happiness. And of course, we're not gonna accomplish very much if we do everything so far. If we do not allow the toxins to leave the body faster than they come in, we're in trouble. Because the toxins, everything you breathe, everything you eat, everything you drink has toxins in it. We know approximately 700,000 toxins we come in contact every day because of the advance of the civilization, which is wonderful, but also with it, it brings a lot of toxicity. It's our job to eliminate these toxins. So how do we eliminate them? First of all, you clean food, organic food, clean water. There are machines out there that will clean the water for you. Take out the chlorides and take the pesticides as much as possible. The foods, organic foods that you don't overcook. And some foods you eliminate. And then, of course, the next thing you have to look at the chemical toxins and how you get rid of the toxins. They have to two ways. One is chelation, which is a process that takes out the heavy metals. Another process, which is sauna, and you have to sweat them out through your skin. So the organophosphates, the pesticides, can only leave your body through the skin. Now, if you go to the regular gym, they have the saunas. You sweat there, which is good, but you do need the FAR- infrared sauna in order to get the toxins out because it destroys them. It will penetrate your fat, your body, and it's a wonderful way to detoxify. And if you have a child that has autism and ADHD, etc., sauna is absolutely wonderful. One of the main things that you have to do. And avoid the toxic food as much as possible. So that's critical. So we have all those treatments here. We do have a sauna. We do chelation. We do all these treatments that you need. But also, you can also chelate by taking vitamin C, which is, again, vitamin C has not been given the credit that it needs. The Australian literature is loaded about the vitamin C. Linus Pauling won the Nobel Prize for it. And of course, traditional medicine has not accepted vitamin C as a big breakthrough. It is a big breakthrough. I can tell you people that have, let's say if you have viral pneumonia, if you have infections, it's a wonder drug. It's not a drug, it's a nutrient. And of course, every one of us should take at least 15 to 20 grams or 15 to 20,000 milligrams of vitamin C a day. If you look at the FDA, this is about 250 to 500 milligrams, which is not enough, absolutely not enough. So if you want to be healthy, the way that we came up with the 15 grams a day, if you look of the mammals, the one weight-wise, the goats are close to humans in weight. They make about 15, they make their own, some animals can make vitamin C, we cannot. So they make about 15 grams a day when they're in normal condition. When they get sick, or the weather gets cold, or they're stressed, they can have up to 100 grams a day. So I have a theory that the people, because we have the gene to make vitamin C, but we don't make it. I cannot prove this theory, but I have a theory of my own, that people that live to be over 100 years old somehow can make their own vitamin C. I haven't proven it yet. I'm going to look into it. But I bet you they can. So one of the greatest breakthroughs that we're going to see in STEM technology in the future, how can we activate the gene that makes vitamin C? Because if we did that, I bet you we're going to have much less disease. So supplementation is critical because the foods, unless you can grow your own organic food with no toxicity, no this, no that, they're fine. But it's impossible if you live in a city, if you have a busy life. I think it's next to impossible to have proper nutrition without proper supplementation. So we can design a specific program for you based on the history and physical, based on the labs, to give you supplementation. And it comes in many forms, from herbs to homeopathics to pills. And of course, in our office, for the convenience of our patients, we carry pharmaceutical grade products so that we know what they are. Keep in mind, if you go to a normal health food store, you have 20% chance of having pharmaceutical-grade products. It was a study done back in the 1970s, no, or 90s, mid-90s. And they looked to see if the outside of the bottle matches the inside of the bottle. Come to find out, only 20% match the outside. The outside and inside only match 20% of the time. They were not pharmaceutical-grade. So I encourage you to, when you take supplements, you spend a lot of money on supplements, make sure at least they're pharmaceutical grade. Okay. So, in summary, proper nutrition, digestion is critical. You strengthen the immune system, you strengthen the brain, you detoxify, and you have supplementation. Now, you must take charge of your own health. The idea that you're gonna trust your health, your body, with me or any other physician is wrong. You're supposed to pick a health practitioner, a health physician that's going to guide you like a coach. I can be the coach. I can, let's say, if I want to play football, I can be the best coach in the universe. But if I tell the players, go and execute, they don't, then it doesn't matter. So you must take responsibility for yourselves. And let's not forget that health also has three components, with the physical, the emotional, and the spiritual. The spiritual, I'm going to leave it up to you because I don't want to interfere with your belief system. The emotional, we can help you with a clear mind to straighten out the emotions. And the physical, we can help you proper nutrition and supplementation and detoxification.
We appreciate all of you coming and spending your hour with us. What we talked about was brain function and how it relates to the immune system and the digestive system, and that all the systems really have to be in balance when you're trying to go for optimal health, or else your thinking is not going to be straight. Please remember to go to our website, like us on Facebook, and be looking for two videos a week, one which will feature a food and then the other which will feature a recipe. And hope to see you again next month at the next Lunch and Learn. Go to our website to find out all the dates coming up. Bye.